Hey, this is John from Alloy 211. Today's video is not so much on firearms, but a recent experience I had purchasing a few firearms from a retailer that I'd never purchased firearms from before. The retailer was Rural King, which if you're not from the United States or if you live in a part of the country where they don't have Rural Kings, Rural King is a store that sells, as the name would suggest, rural products, agricultural products, a lot of just different things along that line. They also sell firearms. Now, as for my experience in store with Rural King, they have a really great, at least in my area, gun counter. The people are very friendly and very helpful, and I really enjoyed that experience of it. But what I didn't enjoy was ordering from them online. And I'll start this out with first one of the guns. I won't get into the other gun until I open the box. But this Heritage Rough Rider, which, as you can see here, I've been wanting to purchase for a while so I can do a comparison between the Rough Rider and the Chiappa 1873-22. They didn't happen to have the barrel length that I wanted in store because I wanted it to be as similar to the other one as I could find within reason. I also bought one with the Magnum cylinder. That's part of the way I justified buying another single action 22, was this one came with the Magnum cylinder and the other one did not. But anyway, I went into the store to see what they had available, and they didn't have that barrel length available. They also, I saw on their website, had this other firearm, this is in this box, and I'll get into it in a minute, at a really good price. So I asked the man behind the counter if I could go ahead and order these at their gun counter, at which point he told me that they couldn't actually order firearms at the gun counter in store. You had to go online to Rural King's RK Guns website and order them and pay for them through the website and then have them shipped to Rural King as if you're transferring them to any other FFL. Now, you can actually have them transfer guns to other FFLs other than Rural King, but to have it done through Rural King is free of charge. So I wasn't really necessarily pleased with that whole route that you had to go, that you couldn't just order them in store, because that seems a little weird. But I thought, okay, you know, I want these firearms and I want this price, and they're a good price. So I went ahead and decided to order them. The first thing that was kind of a pain in the butt with that whole thing is you can't just, you know, order it directly with your credit card information. You have to go through another website, another site to be verified, and then go through that way, which is like an extra pain in the butt. It's like I was ordering something online in 1998. But okay, fine. That's what I had to do. That's what I did. They said 5 to 10 business days normally. They will let you know when it's shipped. Because of the holiday season, add 3 to 5, which again is fine. After 5 days had gone by and I still hadn't received an email giving me any information about what was going on with the $600 I just spent with their company, I decided to call customer service. I was on the phone for about an hour on hold before I gave up because my dinner was cold and my son was antsy. So I gave up, decided to email them. Emailed them. They just gave me the standard answer, which I already knew, 5 to 10 days plus 3 to 5 for the busy holiday season, which is fine, but I really kind of would like to have known because I had an order number and all that, maybe what was going on with my order, but understandably it'd only been 5 days. So at the 9 day mark, 9 business days mark, I decided to call customer service again just to see, because I hadn't heard anything, just to see what was going on. And called customer service after waiting about an hour on hold to get through. I got through, and the woman on the phone was kind of unpleasant to begin with, but, you know, stressed, busy with the holidays, all that stuff. I can be understanding. But then I asked, oh, is there any way I can find out what's going on with my order? I mean, which there's an order number, and I order a lot of things online, and not just that, the business in which I work, we generate order numbers, invoices. Once you've generated that invoice, you can go through and see what's going on with that particular order. And we're not nearly as big of a company as, say, Rural King. And she couldn't tell me anything. Not one bit. I got a little frustrated. I asked to speak to a supervisor, at which point she told me the supervisor wasn't in, but she'd take my number and the supervisor would call me the next day. Next day came and went, the supervisor never called. A few days later, I get an email that the firearms have shipped from one state over from the state in which I live, which is also kind of a little annoying too, because it's like, why is this taking so long when they are literally just going from one state to the other? But fine, that's fine. But more what I found ironic about the whole thing was that after I got the email that the guns had shipped, the next day I get a call, which I didn't answer because it came up as an out-of-state number. And if you or anybody you know maybe has been getting a lot of these cell phone calls from out-of-state numbers that are really just telemarketing, I didn't answer because I assumed, oh, this is just another telemarketer. Well, it was a supervisor from Rural King's customer service wanting to let me know that my guns had shipped. And it's like, well, that's nice. I mean, why couldn't you have called me, say, on that Friday and let me know, hey, this is where we're at in the process, blah, 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 blah. As someone who'd spent, you know, money with their company, that would have been nice. But again, they waited. And another thing that I did find kind of annoying with their customer service was in order to send them a customer service email, I had to sign in, I had to sign up through another website just to do that, just to be able to contact their customer service. And it's like, my God, they give you so many hoops to jump through just to talk to their customer service. Do they really not want you talking to their customer service? And, you know, given the experience I had with the woman I talked to, maybe they don't, because she was not very pleasant. But anyway, I just kind of wanted to do a quick video. You know, people who may be thinking about buying guns from Rural King, I will say, if you go there and they have the firearm in their gun area, I believe they call it the gun corral. You know, it's a agricultural store. They have agricultural names. If they have it in stock and it's there and you can buy it and it's a good deal, pick it up. Now, if they have a gun that you want and it's online, I would maybe advise to say, try to look for another local gun shop that maybe has it in stock and maybe would do price matching or at least get it close, just so you don't have to deal with the whole rigmarole of ordering it online, having it shipped. I mean, it was just a lot more painful experience than what it needed to be. But kudos again to the guys at the gun counter at Rural King. Very nice, very pleasant, very helpful. So anyway, now that I've kind of gotten that unpleasantness past, I already showed you this gun, which we ordered, which I'll be doing a video on, which in some ways it did definitely surprise me. But the other firearm that I purchased, which normally I wouldn't necessarily purchase a firearm like this, but I did here, is a GSG MP40 9mm. And I bought this because Rural King had them, and I don't know what they're selling for now, but about $200 off MSRP. And although I don't normally buy a firearm like this, because this is a pistol 9mm with a long barrel that is kind of ridiculous in some ways, because it's not like an MP40 in that it's semi-automatic. But when I started thinking about it, you know, there's really very little chance I will ever be able to afford an actual MP40. But $400 for a semi-automatic 9mm MP40 look-alike, the way it works is quite a bit different, but it is a look-alike, and I thought, you know, $400, I will get it. And I did. I've yet to shoot it, and before I actually do a video on it, I do want to shoot it so I can give you an idea of its functionality. I'll also say these magazines are proprietary magazines, and they cost like $30 to $40, so I may be trying to see if there's something that we can do to get a cheaper magazine for this thing too. But that's in the future. Today was really just talking about my experience buying guns from Rural King. And like I said, I really appreciate the guys that were at their gun counter. And the prices, I will say this, the price I really appreciated. $200 cheaper than MSRP on this GSG, I wouldn't have bought it for full price. But for $400, well, $440, I think. Where else are you going to get a semi-automatic 9mm pistol with a 10-inch barrel for less than $500? Now, granted, it also has all the weight of a submachine gun, but we'll see how well that works out or doesn't work out for it. And obviously, the Heritage Rough Rider, this was necessary so I could do a comparison between it and the Chiappa, and I think that there will be some surprising things on that one. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you like my other videos, I'd appreciate it if you went ahead and subscribed. Thanks. Have a great day.